I would like to welcome you all for another session of Thoughts on Education, an initiative by College Dunia. I take this opportunity to welcome our eminent speaker, Dr. Ranganayakudu, of principal of Sri Padmavati School of Pharmacy. Welcome, sir. I would like to, can you introduce about yourself and your college in a brief, sir?
Certainly, I feel it's my pleasure to introduce about my institute as well as my career. So I am Professor Ranganayakudu, working in the Padmavati Education Institute, especially that is Padmavati School of Pharmacy, established in 1997. It's the first kind of institution in Rayalaseema regarding the pharmaceutical education. Right from inception, I am here as a principal. Before that, I was at Karnataka, that was the position of principal, that is named Dharwad, that is the Karnataka place. So from there, 1997, I took a charge as a principal. From the day of inception, I'm here and looking up the academic as well as the administration. So it is, I told you very clear, it's a first kind of institute in Rayalaseema where we established the pharmaceutical sciences program, the B-Pharm of 4 years industrial oriented course, where the Padmavati Education Institutions founder is Dr. Mohan Rao sir, late. And later on, 93 sir has been passed out, my correspondent madam, Srimati Sudarshana madam, able guidance and dynamic leadership of our director, managing director P. Pranish sir, we are leading the day onwards. Not only pharmaceutical sciences, the credential of the Padmavati Education Institutions is that all the time, they're the first time to install the kind of the paramedical education in the Rayalaseema. They started with nursing, JNM, later on they fascinated for the B.Ed. And the pharmacy, and later they extended M.C. MBA. And now we are full-fledged with the name school education to up to all professional courses in the pharmaceutical sciences. When we started this program, that is 97, there is no one college in Rayalaseema. We had first premium institute, we established 97. Later on, by team efforts and the management support, I could be able to reach expand my pharmaceutical sciences program with a PG program. That is near all four branches, that is near pharmacology, pharmaceutics, and pharmacochemistry, and pharmaceutical analysis. Like the PG has established in 2007, that is also first kind of PG institute in the Rayalaseema, where the first intake of, say, what you can call 6 to 9 seats in the beginning, that has been extended up to 15 seats for each specialization. Like that, four branches has been taken place. And beginning, B-Pharm was started with a minimum of 40 intake, that it has been enhanced within a reputation and results and no quality of education. The ASD is very kind enough. They granted for 120 intake based on the condition of PCA, Pharmacy Council of India, and to improvise this quality of education, standard of education, not to lead the more rumbling and the admission factor. We restricted ourselves with the limitation of 100 B-Pharm intake. That's the different courses in the pharmaceutical sciences, including the PG program. Later in 2009 and 10, we started the one more new program, worldwide requirement of the pharmaceutical sciences, Doctor of Pharmacy program, 6 years program, plus two, that's named Doctor of Pharmacy program. Later on, there is one more opportunity we have, but there's one first institute in Rayalaseema, we start this program also. And this is the eligibility 6 years program for the plus two level, that's three MCET PPD settlement, the 6 years program. It's purely those who are aspiring for the abroad settlement, this is the doctor program, is so confined, designed for the settlement of the clinical pharmacist in the abroad level. It doesn't mean that they may not be suitable for India, but they are well set, I mean, very good opportunities in the R&D section and the clinical section everywhere. But it's very specially designed those who are aspiring to settle in the abroad. There is a PharmD regular 6 years program. And similarly, where other people are so worried, because those who read this B-Pharma, they want to, the country has an integrated program. So with the request of Pharmacy Council of India, again, there's one more new program has been taken place, that's a post-doctoral PharmD program, that's a minimum entry of B-Pharma. And again, there is a 3 year section, that's integral program, totally 7 years program, it's a post-doctoral PB program of PharmD program. These are the different programs what you are offering in the institute. I'm leading as a professor in the Department of Pharmacology and as an administrator, as a principal, and all the requirements right from the inception of the institute was made, 97 till today.
That's great, great sir, to hear about the brief about your college. Let's get into the discussion about the on thoughts on education. So I'll be asking you straight away questions and you can answer that.
Please.
My first question is, you have held key positions at educational institutions throughout your professional career. What are the key factors that kept you connected with the educational sector till now?
So if you are key factors to fashion for and to continue the education sector, it's a very good letter. So it is firstly, it's a personal and attachment to academia. And my basic qualification, I started my career in education part of Germany. Now I'm a postgraduate in the zoology, MSc. And later I faculty with the diploma and B-Pharma and M-Pharma and PhD and beyond the postgraduate and the doctorate from Andhra University. And in the early days of 80s, there is no one pharmacy college in Andhra Pradesh. There's only Visakhapatnam. There are also plywood only for mathematics students, not BIP students. And so happened as the first batch of BIP students during that tenure. That is in the early 79-80s time. And somehow I'm fascinated. The credit goes to my teachers who taught me in the BSc. They had given some kind of inclination and ignition towards the pharmaceutical sciences. Later on, because the time has been spent, it has made me to pass it once again after completion of BSc. I joined in the Diploma of Pharmacy, assuming that we have some opportunity in the control department. Having the science graduation with the diploma qualification, that's Diploma in Pharmaceutical Sciences, that is a kind of eligibility to enter in the drug control department. That could be one of the reasons to fascinate to continue the farms education for the better settlement. This has been guided by my teacher, the previous course to my professor, Dr. Sri Ramaru, who taught me at the BSc Zoology. Somehow, see why I'm sharing all this. This example may be quite useful for the young generation. See, later on, as soon after completion of my diploma, because there is only 1 year exemption with the BSc, and I discussed my MSc, then I did the diploma. That where I stood gold medal in the diploma level. Karnataka State Government has been offered as a free seat when I passed for the continuation of B-Pharma to extend my updation of my qualification. As it, no, because I am waiting for the opportunity of the opening of the windows regarding the academic administration. Somehow communication gap of the state to state and that been wrong in direction. And it has made me to continue the pharmaceutical education where it has been now where I 90% score in the gate examination where I secure Andhra University PG. Later on, I continue the PhD program in Andhra University. Likewise, education has been extended. So instead of finishing the education with 8 years where it has been pulled for more than 12 years. So my sharing of feelings here. For a youth, especially the students who are coming into the field, they should have a certain mindset because they should have some kind of right bias. Otherwise, that's a waste of time, waste of career. Because if I would have been having this kind of right bias, that would have been set a little earlier. The reason is to take up this pharmaceutical sciences education to settle in the drug control administration department. But later on, after doing all academic updating academic profile, so it has forced me and to enter in the academic. But right from beginning, it is a fortunate or unfortunate, I don't know, but I feel it's a great opportunity for me. Right from 89, I am serving as a principal, that is in Karnataka, up to 97. Later on, I took here as a charge as a principal in Parma School of Pharmacy, as in a part of administrator, as a principal. And as a professor in the Department of Pharmacology. I feel it's there is no more thing to measure with any scale. Teaching profession is such kind of noble profession where you get kind of satisfaction, where I can guide my youngsters, assuming and thinking that my students are kith and kin like, where this kind of desperation should not arise in their career. I've been initiated right from the beginning. It was one of the milestone where I had been told as a a good academician and a good administrator in the part of the entire university, where the example is that, you know, so far we had been completed 21 batches, BFarm has been completed. So, my alumni strength is enormous. Wherever you go in the industry of Andhra Pradesh, Center, South Zone, people have been well scattered with the brand name of SPSP. That is impressed the quality of education here, but the thrust what I had during my persuasion of pharmaceutical sciences, that I could not succeed, that the thrust had been posed by my students who to get through the recruitment examination of the drug control department. We are given the special training the student right from beginning of first year BFarm up to PG levels. That could be one of the results today, where I'm proudly announced more than 32 members of the inspector are existing in Andhra Pradesh from the city store, and 3 additional drug controllers are existing. And even in Tirupati, that my first five student, Mr. Kalyani Chakravarti, is leading as my additional drug controller. That is my students' capacity and strength and quality of education evidence and replica.
That's great.
That could be a rough region where I have been, because I satisfied in the continuation of academic. I have been started my career right from 88 and to till today. It's more than 30 years in the field of academic.
That's great, sir. That's great. Hope you still continue future. My next question is, the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, what can an inborn student gain from studying here in your institute?
Well, sir, it's a very good question. See, as far as my knowledge, the pharmaceutical industry, because pharmacy education, because now here now a number of courses has been arisen. BFarm is industry-oriented course. Based on the industry-oriented course, we have different multi-specialization of PG courses. Like we have only 4, where other colleges, they have different PG programs. So here the PG programs are BFarm, they are meant for the industry-oriented, because we are going to be trying the student regarding the industry requirement of the pharmaceutical products. That's maybe the tablets, capsules, or inject, whatever it may be. Medication preparations are going to be trying the student how to prepare what the quality to be required. These are the kind of design of career we are going to guide the student. But why I'm telling all these things? Because industry sector wise, in the South Asia, Indians are, it has been shown very recently, even preparation of action also, India has become one of the richest place in this, and where we are supplying freely to the different people. That shows what is our capacity of pharmaceutical line, because one-third revenue has been generated in pharmaceutical science. Pharmaceutical industry, India is very rich. Where research and development, where the abroad, as you said, it's, I agree with you. R&D is very fastly developed in Europe and abroad countries. But we are also on par with this. We are also developing. But here I can say one thing. No doubt, our education system in India, especially in the pharmaceutical sciences, it is a practical-oriented course. So whatever they studied about the theory subject of tablet or capsules in the morning session, they are supposed to be trained in the afternoon how to prepare the requirement of the preparations. That's a practical-oriented and quality-based education. So I don't confirm all the colleges are doing this, but those who are in a quality of education, preparing students under quality-based education store. We are very confident, whatever, we don't mind the wastage of product or something else, because we are trained during the tenure of training, daily in the practice period, we used to spend lakhs together and the chemical barrier supposed to pouring in the same. So it is not going to be consumed by the customer. We are training the institute people how to prepare the different formulations, though it may be the one tablet. Tablet also going to vary from person to person. For the infants, children, it is small size. For adults, it's drugs to be required. Sometimes for a patient, it requires the same paracetamol tablet, maybe requires some suspensions like those who are not able to swallow. These are the different technologies required, where technology has to be adopted and properly trained to the student. As per the theoretical knowledge, on par with the theoretical knowledge, we are supposed to train the student to have the adequate experience before it entering the industry. Why I'm very specific on this? These are the very 3 essentials: food, cloth, shelter is essential. Everybody is required. Now, fourth one is it has dominating, predominating everywhere. We know one person in the world without any pharmaceutical product. They cannot exist their life without any pharmaceutical products. That is maybe the tablet or maybe the any product. Everything is being hanged with the pharmaceutical product, right from beginning of morning toothpaste to night pill. So when we have this kind of a merit, our product has to be trained up to that mark. We are so confident with the support of our dynamic director, Pranisha. We are day to day, we are exercising this thing, and we are by force, by initiative, they may not be having that kind of interest students, but we took that kind of initiation with the support of all my well-versed teaching faculty. We are giving appropriate training. Without that training, we are not leaving the people. We are conducting different IDC programs. IDC means there is an inter-development quality programs will be there. Right? We are assigning the work and we are getting the feedback, and we are allowing the first final examination. Without this process, we are not allowing our students. With all this exercise, we are ensuring our quality of education for the student industry oriented. But no doubt, as to the pharmaceutical sciences wise, we are on par with abroad people. Only R&D it has to be established to some more extent.
Great, sir, great. With the competition so high outside, how do you guide your students to survive in such competitions?
That's what I said. It's very much correlated as you ask.
Yeah.
No doubt I agree with you, because when you ask me this very, very good question, especially pharmacy education, I told you in the beginning, there is no one college in Andhra Pradesh in the early 80s. That's what Accra University, the intake of 20. No, if you look at the Andhra Pradesh, it is now before departing, you know, separating of Andhra Telangana, we have more than 380 colleges in both states. So our bifurcation now alone, Andhra Pradesh is having around 158 colleges are existing, and new colleges are going to be added. See, almost one third strength of outcome products from all the institution, it is coming only from the Andhra Pradesh. If you compare nationwide, India-wide, Andhra Pradesh itself is able to produce one third of the graduates every year to the entire country. Based on this, we can assume what is the kind of competition. Now, nowadays, during our completion of graduation and M-Pharma, looking at one M-Pharma, it is in a gold kind line. Now it becomes saturated because production rate is low, and consumption is very limited because openings are very less. And moreover, production rate is high because every institute able to produce every year is 100 strength of the students. During this, it is not the question of industry, because every institute is under some accredited university, but definitely reflects the institute where they study, how they are trying. So based on all these qualities, definitely competition has to play a very vital role. So to overcome all this competency, one should have the kind of commitment. I am proud to say this, my students have been well trained under the three D's, that is name, discipline, dedication, and determination. This is in a quality of education what we have been involved right from the beginning of the day of starting our program. And that is the reason, I can probably announce this on the platform. Last year, we had achieved Divya Sri. Where she stood in a gold medal in the university proper. Likewise, 2014 onwards, we have every year Pratibha Puraskar Award of our own students from B-Pharma, M-Pharma, every year. Except on 2017, remaining all 9 years, we are in a position of watching this Pratibha Puraskar Award. And every year, we have not less than 9 to 11 members in the JEE examination. Competitive examination, that says no very well. That's national examinations. And I'm very proud to say this, Shashikala Bai this year, one of our students achieved the 111 score, that is the highest record in the entire Andhra Pradesh, as in a top ranker in the JEE. See, these are ranks and results. 100 results. Regarding results, we are not worried. So we are doing our best. Team is good, students are good, and no students have that kind of thrust, because day by day students are also very smart. They know how to assess the quality of institute, and they know how to what the demand of requirement or something. So it is in a compatible of nature of the institute. We are giving now endless exercise by that where we could be able to reach all these kind of awards and rewards and where the institutes had got the from the AICT as the top institute in the 2015. This is our exercise, what we are doing. Definitely, this is our exercise. We reflect on the to overcome the competition. Definitely, a student has become competent, they know how to compare the things. Right?
Thank you, sir. What would you like people to know about your institute, which they don't know, like which is not explored enough?
That's true, because now it is the time to showcase ourselves, because whatever we have credentiality, one has to accept based on the quality. If you have the quality we are keeping inside, there's no use. One has to showcase ourselves, for which this is daily, it's coming in the media regarding the ranking or another thing. That's one way it is going to support by website. And secondly, we are initiating the program for a different NRF and accreditations. We are in the process. Definitely, I hope this kind of process is going to pilot for the entire national level and international level. We are going to be trying to enrich the mark of SPS.
When you first came to SPSP Institute, what was your vision for the university? Has it evolved over time? And how far along the implementing that vision are you?
Very good, sir. The day when I stepped into the, that is June 15th, 1997, I took as an, I maybe entered with a different ambitions, but it has made me to fix for the administration of the principal. And now I thought to do some justice for my believers, where my correspondent madam, Subhashi madam, and for directors of Pranisar. So they had given some kind of free hands to develop the institute. Then based on that liberty and faith and other thing, I decided myself, I want to keep my institute at the, not only the university level, in the national level, the way I'm using this word, that time where we have only one program with the 40 intake of BFA. Then I thought to expand the wings of pharmaceutical branches like M-Pharma, different specialty and different new courses. And as you know, it to be flourished like the notable like Manipal and JSS. Like, it was a thought and vision for me to promote the quality-based education, quality students of the society, to cater the needs of pharmaceutical side and to cater the needs of healthcare system. It was in my desire to create kind of hub of pharmaceutical sciences in the same. Of course, by grace of God and the efforts of my team and coordination with my management, I am able to reach this kind of position. Always we are in the top position, to be honest to say, at the university level. And this I want to be enhanced up to the level of South Zone. It was the thought before entering in the field. Somehow I am thinking I could be able to reach some extent. Still there is some lacuna is there, lacuna sense, some gap is there, which has to be fulfilled. That, you know, accreditations, we are in the process. We have to, if we could be able to reach this, I can say that this SP is the ultimate for what it is.
Okay, so hope you achieve that soon. What do you think should be the university's top priority over the next 10 years?
Definitely, it's a very complicated question. You might be heard different multinationals are coming, entering in the India to establish their own universities. Now, the traditional system is going to wipe up, definitely coming for the war, because now COVID has been taught a lot regarding this technical and virtual kind of programs. The days are very near to many countries are establishing the multinational universities in the India, especially pharmaceutical sites. Competition will be more, and we cannot say only one university. Depends on the quality of product, because I strongly believe in this regard. Our product is the best ambassador for us. They will announce and propagate themselves which is the best one, which university is the best one, which industry is best, because no one is going to delay one particular field. Our best ambassadors are the persons is our own student, that based on their existing survivability, because usually people will enter in the institute or university to learn something, and it is happened to be leaves the institute by adequate knowledge, they go for service and survivability. Definitely that quality one, they're going to promote out towards this. It's speak out, it will give the language. Definitely. That's ultimately one thing, quality will speak.
What is the placement strategy of your college, sir? Can you explain us what's the highest package, what's the lowest package, what's the average package?
Yeah, that's a very good question. So we have basically here, majority people early days, 2005, students after completion of B-Pharma, they used to entertain the operation of PG courses like any M-Pharm, they had 20% of the test. At that time, people doesn't have that kind of trust to look up the other alternate, maybe job or something, other allied subject like MBA or something. But later on, 2007 onwards, 2007, 8, up to 9, it's okay. 9 onwards, there is tremendous change has taken place. People are wise, students are very wise and they're very smart in patients. Now, people are not updating their qualification directly, just like that. They are not continuing blindly B-Pharma, M-Pharma like that. And now they are searching suitable jobs because 50% they are passionate for the updation of higher education, that may be M-Pharm or MBA or something. Best of in the among 50%, majority students have been recruited to different. We have MOU with different 7 companies. There is the Matrix Pharmaceutical Sciences in Bangalore and Pondicherry, Cliffs and other pharmaceutical sciences, 3 and Madras 3. And then we have 7 companies stacked. And every academic-wise, curriculum-wise, we used to train every student daily, and we used to conduct IDC programs and everything before examination. But we took very special interest, especially in the end of year of examination, is to depute our staff along with students to visit the industry of nearby the state, that's Madras or Bangalore or something else. They used to visualize what is the academia, what is the industry requirement. Just a glass of look, just having a glass of look in their mind when they click what is the requirement for the industry. Likewise, when having their 1 or 2 time visits, the mindsets may be changed for the students. Definitely it has given very good results because people are being fascinated with the thrust of settlement with the B-Pharma. Measured more than so on today, 367 students for this last 4 academic years. These 367 students have been based in the different areas, industry, including Aurobindo, wherever you go, you can take the strategy. Majority of pharmaceutical industry, either it may be the Hyderabad, other places very limited now, it is coming up. Majority of overall India, Bombay, next Bombay to Hyderabad, the pharmaceutical industry. Majority of Hyderabad industries, every industry is more than 20 to 25% people they belong to HPS. You go for any industry. That is my richness and strength of my student. That's what the support is, my alumni, my students' alumni. Because they have the kindness to support the juniors. And we have placements and we have the rapport and the student. And our better settlement students now we used to control the campus interviews for the different companies we used to offer. That's with our mutual MOU with the other investors. So that is the figure, 367 members have been recruited last 4 year strategy.
What's the highest package, sir, of your student, any student?
The initially for B-Pharma, they're offering right from beginners as a around 16,000 to 20,000 rupees as usual. It is the tendency is running like that. And later on, so I'll give an example. B-Pharma, one of our first or second batch students, they settled highest position as general manager position like the reach, they're drawing more than 1 lakh package. Not package, it's month wise.
Yeah.
There are certain people, 36 lakh package also. Which I mean, what I'm telling
you. So what is the highest package of the last year batch? Last year batch.
Last year, it is around, it's lying 28 to 30. With M-Pharma. With B-Pharma, it is limited of 20 to 25.
That's good.
With 1 year experience. Whereas PharmD people are with a 1 year, PharmD program is clinical oriented. So they initially started with 25 and there are in plus or minus of 35 to somewhere else.
Good. Any suggestions you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
With this kind of program where you can make aware of the youngsters to overcome their ignorance or confusing factors. Because people are coming not with a kind of choice, especially the pharmaceutical senses. So after completion of plus two, they have some many viability conditions, imagination towards only medicine sector, especially usually people are coming from BPC sector. They have thought towards the first priority, the social strategies is nothing but MBBS. Then later on, they look for some other allied courses like BBS or BBS. Quite naturally, people are now coming with a last child, kind of chance like they are coming in the pharmacy field. So I would like to convey the message on this platform. I strongly believe there is no course is superior, no course is inferior. But pharmaceutical sciences program is such kind of program. It is not confined with one allied sector. So it might be BA candidate may become IAS or something else. That is different. That's what I told. There is no inferior course or no superior course. But where the pharmaceuticals like engineer, they have only one path. Like, lawyers, they have only one profession side. So every professional course, they have one track. But where the pharmaceutical sciences, they have different spectrum of their job opportunities. I'll say, that's what I told you, because entire world has become dependent on the pharmaceutical product. So as long as the demand of your pharmaceutical product is the evergreen subject, your career will be good and your prospects will be good. Not like, booming, I don't want to compare with other person. My profession, pharmaceutical profession is evergreen, never endless. And so why in second I'm saying, the other sector. Then, since we have this kind of demand of this course, we have, along with this pharmaceutical industry jobs, because in the industry we have different 14 lines in the quality assurance, quality productions, and marketing. Marketing is the sky is the limit in this, especially people who have this marketing experience with the 1 or 2 years of the pharmaceutical graduation, they have the highest post as a product manager, where minimum package will be start with a 50 plus. That's the kind of opportunity. And ultimately, you have some other kind of additional support, like a pharmacology or something. That is hot cake like. Where you can, starting, you can expect with 1 lakh package. That's product manager. The role and responsibility that they are supposed to prepare all the recipes and something to promote the product towards and to communicate these things for the physicians. That's very key role. So where other people also can market, but pharmaceutical product candidate, if he's marketing side, that is, quality-wise, he can explain, he can promote the quality of drugs to the public need. That's one thing, marketing. Likewise, in industry, we have more than 14 lines. Along with this, everybody has to aware of this. B-Pharm is liable to compete on par with the other graduates. They are liable for all group and group examinations and banking examinations, and drug control department like drug inspectors and the government analysis post. Likewise, now it is a plenty opportunity of the course. It's we have the wide spectrum compared to other senior. One BBS candidate, they can go only for veterinary side. Then one engineer, he has to go with an online line. Whereas the pharmacist is not, it is a very wide scope that how best you can make use as an your virtual, you can go ahead. That's what I feel proud myself. That I'm belongs to the pharmaceutical
science. Actually, I do did not know that pharmacy students can go in these directions. It was great, sir.
Yeah, many people doesn't.
It was great, sir. Thank you for your insights about your college, about your normal discussion.